It's news time. Information is power.
The current.
The news headline.
Why it may be difficult for Buhari to grant the request of the Southeast monarch.
The news in full.
Recently, the Southeast traditional rulers, monarchs, archbishops, and bishops called on the federal government of Nigeria to put things in order for peace to return to Southeast. According to a report on Tribune Online, the Southeast monarch and bishops listed about three conditions they want the federal government to meet for there to be peace in the Southeast. Some of the conditions they listed were 1. Demilitarization of the zone. They requested that the federal government should withdraw soldiers from Southeast. Description: the proscription of the indigenous people of Biafra, IPOB. They requested that the federal government needs to reverse a decision and stop labeling IPOB as terrorists. 3. The release of Mazi Nnamdi Kanu. They also requested that the leader of the indigenous people of Biafra, IPOB, Mazi Kanu, Nnamdi Kanu, should be released. The writer is of the opinion why it may be difficult for Buhari to consider the following request. Looking at the request made by the Southeast traditional rulers, it is very clear that none of them is easy to grant. When you talk of the demilitarization of the Southeast as they requested, how would they expect the federal government to withdraw the military from the Southeast, seeing how unknown gunmen are yet attacking, killing innocent citizens and security agents? The unknown gunmen in the Southeast are still proving very stubborn. Even while the military is there, one would imagine if the military should withdraw from that such region, I think that they may give them more room to perpetrate their heinous acts. Now, talking of the proscription of the indigenous people of Biafra, IPOB, how would they even think that the government would proscribe IPOB, seeing that IPOB has a terrorist agenda? Is there any difference between terrorists and the IPOB that delights in killing security agencies and destroying government properties? Seeing that IPOB operates like Boko Haram, it means that if federal government should deproscribe the indigenous people of Biafra, known as IPOB, definitely it means that Boko Haram may also request that the federal government should stop regarding them as terrorists. Talking of their third request, which is to release Nnamdi Kanu, I think there is a rule of law on how court cases are being handled in Nigeria. We remember that Kanu has been facing court charges since 2015, of which he allegedly turned bail in 2017, and was nowhere to be found until he was rearrested on June 29, 2021. Germane to his arrest in 2015, Kanu has also been facing charges bordering on terrorism, treasonable felony, managing an unlawful society, illegal possession of arms, and so on. Meanwhile, his case is yet to be concluded in court. His case was last heard on October 21, 2021, and was adjourned till November 10, 2021. Therefore, since the court is yet to conclude his case, it will be very difficult for President Muhammadu Buhari to release Mazi Nnamdi Kanu. And this is an analysis by a postmaster public analyst trying to look at the easiness of Mazi Nnamdi Kanu, which is the leader of the indigenous people of Biafra, be released from detention, aside other requests that the southeastern leaders had actually put forward to President Muhammadu Buhari after considering the level of mayhem and heinous crimes going on in the southeastern part of the country. Therefore, the Southeast leaders, as well as religious leaders, had actually appealed and urged President Muhammadu Buhari to see reasons with them why he needs to adhere to the three conditions that they have listed, you know, for peace to return to the southeastern part of the country, which included withdrawing soldiers from the southeastern part of the country. Soldiers have actually been manning the nooks and crannies of the Southeast because of the mayhem going on in the environment, and also the release of Mazi Nnamdi Kanu, the leader of the IPOB, who was extradited from Kenya back to Nigeria, and also the proscription of the indigenous people of Biafra, which actually means that since the federal government has actually listed the IPOB as a terrorist organization, the Southeast leaders and Christian religious leaders in the Southeast are actually saying that there is need to, you know, pronounce them yet again as non-terrorist organization. That means for the fact that they are referring to them as a terrorist organization before, then the federal government should stop, you know, give an order that they are no longer a terrorist organization. And this was a third request. And the writers of the opinion that the reasons why this will be difficult for Buhari to do is because presently the military men are still manning the southeastern part of the country, and yet we still record a whole lot of criminal activities, killing, murdering, raping, you know, kidnapping, and a whole lot others that is actually making the people of the southeast to lose their lives and properties. Yet the military are still within that locality and region. So therefore, if the military should actually vacate that premises, what would happen? It actually infers that it would be more worse than it is presently. And that is why the writer is of the opinion that this particular request may not be easy to grant, because withdrawing them will lead to continuous killing, in fact, free killings of innocent citizens and also security agents, because the unknown gunmen in the southeast are yet still proving very stubborn, even while the military are there, and evacuating them or demilitarizing the region would actually give them more room to perpetrate their evil acts and also heinous doings. And that is why the writer here is of the opinion that it is not easy, or it should not actually work out in the regards of the of the federal government granting this condition by the Southeast leaders, and also the proscription of the indigenous people of Biafra, saying that if the federal government should yet again say that the IPOB are no longer a terrorist organization, therefore the Boko Haram members would actually have same wings, you know, to seek that they are no longer a terrorist organization. And that is why it is sacrosanct to be very careful in not deproscribing the indigenous people of Biafra IPOB, seeing that the IPOB also operates like the Boko Haram, and this request might actually not be regarded by the federal government of Nigeria. And talking of their third request, which is to see the release of Mazen Nnamdi Kanu, the writer is of the opinion that the release of Mazen Nnamdi Kanu so far is within the jurisdiction of the court, has to be decided by the court, because at a particular point in time, Mazen Nnamdi Kanu was alleged to have jumped bail, although the writer has failed to make known that the jumping of bail was due to the fact that the military invaded Mazen Nnamdi Kanu's home, where a whole lot of lives were lost, even including his parents were lost, and it was, you know, kind of reasonable for him to flee for his life to be saved. And therefore, he was actually extradited from Kenya back to Nigeria, which was actually unlawful. And that is why the lawyer of Mazen Nnamdi Kanu had actually been agitating, you know, and soliciting that the federal government of Nigeria be sued, you know, and be tamed in this regard for actually using an unlawful means to bring Mazen Nnamdi Kanu back to Nigeria. Thanks for listening.